Hello, I am Mal, and welcome back to Master of Orion Let's Play as the Sakkra Empire. Okay, so let's see. We got rid of those pesky humans. Yeah, that was nice. Finally got rid of them. So now what we need to do is sort of backfill these other systems. We're going to go down here and we're going to get rid of Bob, the space dragon. So we're going to get rid of Bob, and then we'll get access to this nice little planet here. Ibis Prime. And then we need to focus on getting the tech that will allow us to go through these locked warp points. Now, at this point, I'm not sure. I mean, part of me says, yeah, let's get to that tech as soon as possible and sort of bust through. But it would also be nice if we made sure we had like all of this stuff built up back here before we did it. So we'll just have to see. All right, so let's see. What do we got over here? Civil transport's going. Okay. Go up here and put something on that gas planet. Civil transport. Okay, let's look at planets. Oh, not planets. Let's look at the Empire. There we go. Population. These sorters, like, don't work still, which is kind of unfortunate. Yeah, like, why isn't this sorting, like, top to bottom? I don't know, but it's not. Unless it's doing it by max. Even at max pop, it's not sorting correctly. Well, hopefully they figure that out. Let's see. Where could we send? I guess we could send population to Sol Prime. You know what? Let's do that because I want to test and see whether or not having mixed races on the same planet, if that creates an issue. It used to in Master of Orion 2, so let's test it and find out. And since you can't transport off a specific population, I wonder how you fix that if there is an issue. Don't know. Okay. Let's unload these. There we go. Now we're max pop here. Do it like that. Yep, we have just enough food stuff here. Actually, we have more than we need. Seems like right now it seems like the food thing is a bit overboard. Yeah, I'll leave the structures in for now, but it seems like the food's a little too easy. I mean, I am doing the Sakkra, so the growth thing is factored in and whatnot, but still, this is pretty crazy. And this is a desert world. It's not like this is like some really nice place. Yeah. Well, in any case. All right, let's take a look at the Empire again. Okay, looks good. Okay, we're gonna send you, Mr. Transport. Did I say go up here? Okay, there we go. Research is done.
Wait.
Nice, we'll take the drive. Update the plans. Yeah, upgrade them all.
Wait.
Now, choose new research. Terraforming? I really kind of want that. Let's do it. Upgrade this? No, I don't need to upgrade that and spend money. That's silly. Use production. Do some more pollution cleanup, I guess. Do I grab hydroponic or do I grab hydroponic? Ought to be good, actually. Yeah, we'll just go like this, and then this guy should be able to pull off and go up here. Yeah, it should be balanced to zero. Yeah, it should. Let's go ahead and do advanced data center. You come off of there? You can. Okay, great. Right, because you've got the bonus and it's a Terran biome. That's pretty sexy. Okay, and up here. Advanced data center. It's going to take four turns and then we'll shift. Probably shift to all research on this planet for a while, actually. And let's go ahead and scrap this military outpost. We don't really need it anymore. Okay, max pop. And get rid of that. And what are we gonna build? Don't really need a missile base here. Nah, not really. All right, let's shift to research then. There we go. That's that's quite a bit. And then for our generic production, we'll just do trade goods. Genetic mutation complete. So we've got 0.5 per scientist that's doing research bonus, and then we have terraforming. Nice. Okay, choose research. Subterranean farms. Gas giant compression. Oh. Hmm. Combat speed bonus plus 60%, travel speed 3. Hmm. Grab artificial gravity for moon labs. Okay, simulate. Okay, goodbye, pirate fleet. Oh, another cruiser. Nice. Well, I guess we'll just hang out right there for now. Ready to go exploring once we get the tech. Pollution is at 25%. Minus 6% per turn because of the atmospheric renewer and the toxic processor thing. Yep. And we can actually move up a class to terraforming. Okay, let's do that. Mm-hmm. And then let's do that here as well. So every time you do this, like as an example here on this world, we're going to go from desert to like arid, and then it would be arid to Terran, and then Terran to Gaia transformation. Unless that's a separate tech, it could be, but it's probably not. In which case, this is just going to get more expensive each time, but it's worth it because it radically improves the world, right? So let's see. What are you? You're Terran. Can we do Gaia? Will it let us? It will not. Okay, so it looks like either it's a separate tech or you can't do Gaia transformation. We could turn this right here. Once we have the requisites, or do we have it already? Hold on. Are we researching? Brainers are still stirring. Oh, we'd have to get planetology. Okay, never mind. We'll stick with artificial gravity for now. All right, next turn. I need a colony ship 2 somewhere. I guess you can do it. Yep. Grab that. Okay, artificial gravity's done. Orbital shipyard or moon laboratory. I think I'm gonna go for research, actually. I don't know, ship cost minus 20% is pretty good. No, taking the research.
The brainers are-
Okay, now, let's grab... Go ahead and grab planetology. Let's unload here. Doesn't seem like having a different pop on a planet matters, so that's good, I guess. Okay, we'll keep working on pollution reduction. Let's do that first, though. Let's finish the toxic processor. Okay, who else got a moon? You do. You've got 2. Does that mean you can build 2 moon labs? That would be awesome if you could, but I'm assuming no. That'd be too overpowered, I guess. What do we got here? Civil transport, huh? Okay. Go over to Seoul, then. And we're gonna wait on this, because we can do... gas giant compression once we have, the tech for it. I think I'd rather do that. Like, yeah. We're gonna wait and experiment with that a little bit. Your max pop again? That's fine, because you're about to get done with the colony ship, so... all good. And your max pop, too? Okay. Can I leave it that way? I think I will leave it that way, because... we've got enough food to sustain us with nobody in here, so they can do extra research right now. And then... in terms of... production... yeah, we'll continue like this, and then once this is upgraded to Terran, we should have more spots here. Yeah, we need terraforming to unlock. So we'll see what that happens with that, and then we'll shift some people around. Okay, you can just sleep right there. Next turn.
Got a piece of thinking for Big Boss.
Who's critical? Okay, yeah, you kind of are. But the pollution processor is supposed to be done. What can I say? It should be done soon. All right, we'll go ahead and go to clean up then. Yeah, we'll go like that. And someday my fleet will get down there to deal with Bob the Space Dragon. That's the hope. Okay.
The brainers are.
But now we've got subterranean farms. And then we've got gas giant compression and artificial planet. So this is if you want to convert like an asteroid field. Let's see. Okay, now let's choose. And our research is starting to just fly up. Astrobiology. Biomorphic fungi. Including hard vacuum and radiated worlds. Huh. Okay. Grab antimatter fission.
Yes, big.
Next population in 4 turns. That works. Now, we could actually do subterranean farms here, because this is sort of like our food world, right? This is the one where we keep creating civil transports and sending the population elsewhere. We could continue to do that with this world, and I think that I will. But how much is subterranean farms? It's 4 maintenance, which is kind of costly, but at +2 food, +1 per cell, that's kind of crazy. Yeah, so let's do this. Let's grab a moon lab first. And then, yeah, we're going to grab all the food stuff for this planet. And this is going to be our population producer world. Yeah, let's go ahead and grab another civil transport. And put it like right there. That'll work. This will be completed in 4 turns. We'll have max pop, then we'll build that and we'll transfer one off. Yep, works. Colony ship. You're headed this way. Okay, and then up here, gas giant compression. So we can do +1 credit, which is not bad, but honestly, wouldn't it be better to have either a large or huge barren world here? I think so. 20 turns. All right, well, it takes a while. That's to be expected. Okay, let's unload this. Almost got you back to max population. That's nice. Get rid of your pollution, and you're going to be a nice little world we got there. It's artifacts world, too. So extra research. Not that we're having any problems with research points at this point.
This is GNN.
The Sakkra Brood achieved a major breakthrough in science today.
Oh, did we now? Okay.
And now, the state of the galaxy. Current leaders of advanced technology.
Oh, wow. Okay. Okay. So, reached major breakthrough in science, so we completed our research project.
Wait.
We're going to take drives. We're going to update all of our blueprints to include that. Now, choose new research. Okay, now research is going like crazy fast. So, let's see. We want to grab... Look at the tech tree, actually. We're trying to get... Multi-state insulator. This is where we're trying to get. Alright, let's go ahead and do that then. We'll just work on text that'll get us there. We're coming for you, Bob. We're coming for you. How did we discover that? What did we finish?
The brainers are over and
tachyon scanner? Oh, detect disturbances. Oh, okay. We increased our tachyon sensor range. Okay. All right. Well, we're not going to update blueprints because I don't want to put battle scanners on every ship. I don't think so. Let's just choose another research. Do the tech tree. We'll just click on this thing again. Okay, so robotics is next. Mm-hmm. Oh, we're finding stuff. That's kind of cool. What's next in your queue? Oh, you finished your queue. All right. Thank you. Maybe put in Toxic Processor or Atmospheric Renewer. Probably don't need both here. Alright, so let's put this in and then let's do some terraforming. Want to see how fast it'll grow with no one on food. Yeah, we'll find out next turn. Okay, robotics research completed.
The brainers are over and
so, ground batteries, automated repair unit, which is actually quite nice. All repaired at 5 per second. That's pretty awesome in combat, so you can do kind of hit-and-run tactics. They're probably going to find that that bi-second thing is going to be a little bit OP. Yeah, just basically on the way tactical combat works right now, I can already see this being, like, huge. And then Dauntless Guiding System, missiles fired from ship request new targets, should their primary objective be destroyed before they make impact, greatly increase the effectiveness of large volleys of warheads. Oh, I see. Yeah, it'll pick another target. That might actually be worth putting on my ships.
Oh, those brainers are still...
Okay, now we're going with Magnetogravitix. So max pop in 11 turns with no one on it. We'll leave one person on it though. 6 turns. Yeah, I like this plan of making this the planet that cranks out population for everyone else. Yeah, this works. Let's grab another civil transport or two. And we'll do it like that. That'll keep that busy. Are we down there with Bob yet? Almost. Can we fight Bob? We can fight Bob. Nice. Oh, there he is. Bob the Space Dragon. Oh, he looks kind of mean. All right, let's pause it for a second. Mm-hmm. Wow, he's kind of buff. What are you attacking with there, Bob? A dragon's breath? And what's its arc? Oh, you have pretty limited range there, Bob. Ha ha ha. All right. Here, let's pull back. Can I get him to come to us? Or maybe your range isn't as limited as I thought. Oof. Okay, you break off. Come here. Come here. Ah, I'm gonna lose this one probably. Oh, maybe not. He's not firing on it, which is strange. Keep these ships in the back. Oh, or we can win. That works too. Nice. So that's how, okay, so that's probably the best way to fight a space dragon then, is that since it's got that big firing arc, you can send a bunch of smaller ships behind it, while maybe one or two ships kind of kite it at the beginning. Yeah, I think so. Well, that's fine. We killed him. That was good. We didn't lose anything. Almost lost a cruiser, but we didn't. So let's see. Uh-huh. So the Barathea are just on the other side here, huh? Okay. Let's go here. We need another space factory, actually. Yeah, you there. Come here. Build it here since it's close. Or even here, for that matter. Yeah, let's build a couple of them. Can do terraforming? Did I already set that up? I guess it didn't. We can turn this into a Terran world. Right. Okay. Well, that's what we're gonna do next then for you. We'll transport. You can head down here. And let's go ahead and colonize this. Nice.
This is GNN, Galactic News Network.
The Sakkra Brood has grown in strength, spanning even more planets and showing no signs of stopping.
That's right. No signs of stopping. All right, we will go ahead and hang out here at this warp point. We'll build a military outpost there. And then as soon as we unlock the tech to go through, if everyone's repaired and upgraded, we can proceed with smashing more phase. Okay, you grew. Still working on pollution cleanup. All right. Keep guarding that. Okay, so no pollution. Well, I guess advanced data center. 5 turns, okay, and then let me go update my designs here real quick. Edit. Okay, we've already got antimatter drive. Okay. On a computer. Automated repair unit. Yes, please. I'm gonna have to take some weapons out, which I'm fine with. Why did you upgrade to mass drivers? Is that a PD? Oh, it is a better point defense weapon. Okay, well, that's fine, but then we need to lower the amount of offensive weapons that we have to pick up automated repair. No, I'm still not gonna fit. How much is that? 50? I get rid of a couple of mass drivers. Do that. That should fit. All right, done. And displacement device. No. Get rid of that. Put that on there. I didn't even want it. How about death spores? Can I put another one of those on? No. Another weapon? Alright, we'll try the mass drivers out as point defense. That's good. I mean, already in use. The destroyer. All right. Done with that. plus one food here, so I can't really get rid of anything, but that's fine. Terraforming here? Yeah, okay. To make it Terran. Empire in deficit, okay. I hate raising taxes, but it's an unfortunate have-to thing. Something that can bomb that up there. Here, come here. You go here. Guard, and next turn.
I am the Emperor of the Bulrathi. If you wish to keep your flea-bitten pelt on your back, you'll give my kindred a wide berth.
Yeah, okay. Sounds good. Go talk to him real quick. See if we can establish an embassy or something. They believe we're colonizing too fast? No, yeah.
What is it you want?
I can't say that I don't disagree with him. We are doing it pretty fast. Okay, so let's see if we can establish an embassy and share charts. Okay.
In this, there.
All right, so they went for it. Nice. Exchange tech. This is a good way to find out what they don't have too. So you could do exchange tech, and then you can say, "Hey, you want any of this stuff that you don't currently have?" So we know they don't have any of that. That's fine for now, though. Alright, folks. Whoa, look at that. We know where a bunch of stuff is now. That's nice. Interesting. Okay, well, I hope you've enjoyed this episode, and if you have, please consider hitting that thumbs up. Thanks so much for watching. Until next time, I am Mal, and I will see you later.